Hello, my dear ones. Today we're going to talk about asking the blessing of your parents. And what do I mean by that? I mean by that is if you are dating somebody, like, ask the blessing of your parents. Like, if you like somebody, then the next best thing is to do is to bring this person home so that this person can sit with your family, and then your family can see them and can talk to them and can know and get to know them. Because, darlings, you have to know that your family is not in love with this person. And that's why your family can see everything really clearly. Because if we like somebody and if we are in love with somebody, then we cannot see things clearly. Like, if there were the red flag in this person, you see as very cute things. Like, let me give you two examples. Like, you say, like, oh, he gets angry very easily, but he's so cute when he's angry. Or maybe you may say, like, oh, she's not very serious in a walk with God, but she's so beautiful, and I can teach her, and I can pray for her, and I can pray her for it, and maybe I can lead her to God. No, darlings, these are two signs from God. Like, if somebody doesn't really have a relationship with God, then it's very hard for this person to serve God, because the person that you are dating should be open to serving God and to giving their life to God. And if you are dating somebody who already in the beginning stages can get angry very easily, it means that this person doesn't have his emotion under control. This means actually also this person is not stable. So that's why, my dear ones, we cannot ignore the signs. And your family, they will point out things that you will not see, because you like this person so much and you love this person so much. And if you like somebody, then we always make excuses for somebody. But dear ones, I beg of you, take this decision very seriously, because 99% of your happiness is dependent on the person that you get married to, because this person, they can become a blessing or they can become a burden, and we don't want that, because now we have the choice. Now we can walk away, but later if we are married to this person, then it's really hard to walk away because we made a commitment to God. That's why, my darlings, always take the advice of your parents. Like, for me, I know, if I ask the advice of my mom, and my mom doesn't like this person, it has nothing personally to do with this guy, nothing. But I know that she doesn't like this person. For me, that I know this is a sign from God, because I know my mom is my biggest fan. She wants me to be happy. She wants me to get married. She wants me to have, like, a beautiful family. Like, if she says no, then you have to know, like, something is wrong. And sometimes we cannot see the thing. Maybe you can see the thing, like, in a couple of months, in a couple of years. But always trust the signs from heaven. Because, and also, don't make excuses for the person that you are dating. And what do I mean by that? Like, if your dad or your mom say, you know what, darling, I think she's a very nice girl or a very, very nice boy, but I think I suggest you to pay attention on this area of this person's life. Or I suggest you to ask this question to them. Or I suggest you to do this in your relationship. They say to you, have you noticed that this person does this a lot? Or have you noticed that this person doesn't do this? Like, don't make excuses for this person. Don't get angry at your parents. Never get angry at your parents. Always listen to your parents. Always respect your parents, because the person that you are dating should bring joy, peace, and love in your family. But if this person that you are dating already bring division in your family, then this is also a sign from God that this person is not sent by God. God will not bring you somebody who would bring attention to you and to your family. God will bring you somebody who will make you love your family. Make you love your family more, because this person should actually draw you closer to your family. Because if this person cannot draw you closer to your family, how can this person later draw you closer to God, dear one? That's why you have to be very smart about this. Wisdom is making the decisions now that you will be happy with tomorrow. So don't think about now. Don't think about, I like this person, really, really beautiful on a photo together. No, don't think about your social media status. Don't think about your single status or don't think about your status. Just think about, like, you know what? I want to please my parents. I want to love my parents. I want to respect my parents. But maybe you're thinking by yourself, like, Sina, I want to do all those things, but my parents, they don't believe in God, or my parents are very unstable. I come from a very broken home. Then I suggest you to do this. I suggest you to go to church, and you go and you look for somebody who you know who have, like, very good fruit in their life. What do I mean by very good fruit? That this person is a very good mother or a very good father. And then you go up to this person. You say, you know what? Can I ask you a question? I want to ask your wisdom on this topic. I am dating this girl or I'm dating this boy. What do you think about that? And also ask your priest. Like, if I would be dating a guy, I would always ask my priest, like, what do you think of him? And what do you think about this relationship? Like, your relationship should be open for opinions, because if your relationship is very isolated, that's not healthy. Your relationship should be very open. It should be very transparent. Everybody should have everybody. Your relationship should be so open that if somebody says something, that's what I try to say, that you will not be offended, because you need to be so open in the beginning, because you don't know if this person is your future wife or your future husband. So that's why you need to guard your heart. You cannot say, like, already, like, oh, this person is the love of my life, I'm gonna marry this person. No, wait. Wait from the signs of heaven. Like, ask the opinion of your parents. Talk to your parents, and your parents say, you know what, I don't think this person is good for you, ask your parents the reason, and just think about it, pray over it, and guard your heart in the beginning stages. And if your parents say, you know what, I'm gonna give you my blessing, or your priest, or people who you trust, like Christian people who follow God, like very good Christians. Like, we don't ask opinions of the world, because we don't want to follow the world. So that's why it's very, very important to ask the opinion of people who already have, like, a successful Christian marriage, who already, like, following God together, because these people also know what it takes. And you have to know, like, your parents are your number one fan. Like, your parents want you to be happy. Your parents want you to get married. That's why if your parents say something about your relationship, be open to it. Like, be open with it, with an open mind. Like, don't be offended. And take everything your parents say. Take this very serious and bring this to God. Say, you know what, God, I like this girl, I like this boy, but my mom or my dad, they say this and this and this. What do you think about it? Because it's very beautiful if you go into something that we go into this with a blessing. Because many people get married and they don't ask the blessing of the parents, and later they are in a bad relationship, or even worse, they are in a bad marriage, and some people are very they don't want to admit, like, I made a mistake, or, you know what, I should listen to my parents. So it's very good to concern now your relationship, and to see if this person is sent by God, yes or no. That's why, how do you know? Very easy. How do you know if this person is sent by God? If this person is sent by God, this person will give you peace. It will bring joy in your family. It will give you peace in your heart, and will not bring confusion in your family. So never fight with your parents about a girl or a boy. Nobody is worth it. Always respect your parents. Always respect the opinion of your parents. And if you say, like, I don't come from a godly family, I don't come from a stable family, you go to God. You say, God, you are my heavenly father, and I need heavenly advice. I need fatherly advice. What do you think about this relationship? Speak into my relationship, God. Speak to me. I am here. I listen to you. But that's why if people give us direction, then it's up to us. And we need to listen to them. We need to listen to them, and we have to know that these people say these things for our well-being. That's why my dear one. So pray about it, think about it, fast about it, and ask God for wisdom for in this situation that you were in. Ask God for that He will lead you. But that's why it's very important once again to ask the blessing of the people around you. So I'm gonna leave it at that, and I hope this video can encourage you, that if you are dating somebody, that that you say, you know what, I'm going to invite them to my home, I'm going to invite them to come to have a meal with my parents, I'm going to invite them to come to have to sit with my parents. And also something very big, the person that you should date should have a very big interest for your family. Like if this person already in the beginning stage don't like your parents and don't like to spend time with your family, that's also a very big sign, because this person should also draw you closer to your parents. Because if this person already don't love your family, already don't like your family, then this means that this person want to isolate you, and isolation doesn't come from God. The man or the woman that God sent you, they want to draw you closer to your family, they want to draw you closer to God. That's a very important sign, my dear one. Don't take this sign very lightly. Take this very seriously. And if you are dating somebody who doesn't like your family, then I suggest the best thing to do is to break up with this person right now. Because if this person doesn't like your family, doesn't respect your family, this person cannot love you and cannot respect you. Like even if you say, you know what, I have a very bad relationship with my mom, with my dad, with my family, but the person that you are dating should first of all respect your family, should honor your family, and should have the desire to become a peacemaker between you and your family. Because in the Bible said, blessed are the peacemaker. But if you are dating a boy or girl, and if you say to them, you know what, something about your family, and they say, you know what, yes, you are right, your family is, your mom or your dad, they were very bad and blah blah blah, and they speak very poorly, negative about your family, then you know this person is not for you. So it's better to say goodbye now than to say goodbye tomorrow, because this person is not the person for you. Because dear one, you have to know, I want you to become happy. I don't just want you to have a boyfriend, no, or a girlfriend. I want you to be with the person that God has for you, because I know God has somebody for you. Because in the Bible says, I knew you when you were in the womb of your mom. So God has a very beautiful plan for you, and I don't want you to be desperate, because you are a son or daughter of God, and I know you are worth so much more. So that's why don't be desperate. Wait for God. Trust God. Trust the opinions of your family, and trust the opinions of the people around you. So be open, be prayerful, and watch for the signs of heaven.